going on YouTube? Stan, here's another video. I think this is the first time I have my dad's 91 GMC on the channel that I'm actually doing something with it. Nothing really particular about this. Really needs any explaining. I'm just changing the thermostat on the, I'm just changing the thermostat in the truck. Kind of flushed right now. It's kind of late, not super late. But anyways, enjoy this video. What I want to talk about that you'll probably see by the title and the thumbnail down on the ground right here. And that's what this video is about, but I'm going to time lapse into me doing this. So you guys hang tight. Hope you enjoy this video. Give this video a like. I got one challenge for you guys before I forget. Give this video a like. I want 30 likes on this video. Like I said, I think we got pretty cool little truck right here. Plus, I'm really excited about the heads. So like I said, give this video a like. 30 if you're watching the video 6 months from now and it's not to 30. Make sure you give this video 30 likes. I'd really appreciate that. Other than that, let's get into it. Alright YouTube, so I hope you're enjoying this video so far. Make sure you watch it all the way to the end. But I've got one thing to ask you. Go down in the description of this video and hit those Amazon affiliate links. But let me explain how it works. You see this box in my hand? This is a Noco Genius 10. But if you don't know what this is a portable jump box. Lately, more than I would like to admit, me and my dad have needed a jump box. Well, his birthday's coming up, so I figured, how can I solve this problem and get him something that he can actually use? Well, I said, let's get him a jump box. Hopped on Amazon, clicked on my Amazon affiliate link, and bought it. So this is going to be the first link in the description below. But here's the trick. If you just click on those links, whether you're buying something for yourself or for someone else as a gift or surprise or anything like that, it uses my affiliation all the way throughout your checkout. So like I said, it's that simple. Just click the link. It takes you to Amazon. Buy whatever your heart desires, and I get a little kickback. But you don't have to give me money. You're going to give it to Amazon anyway, so just help me out. Like I said, I really hope you enjoy the video. That's it. While I wait for everything to seal up and dry up so I can double check the coolant system, I figured I'd give you guys a quick rundown on this truck because it hasn't really been on the channel much at all. So basically, if you can tell, the garage is kind of hard to see in here sometimes, but this is a 91 C1500 GMC with a 350 single cab step side bed. And then here's a crown jewel to the whole setup. All right. This ain't like one of those new vehicles where you can both sides unlock. But anyways, the crown jewel to the whole thing, it's a 5-speed. So 5-speed manual 350 truck, the sport bucket seats, so not just the bench seat, the gray sport bucket seats. You got your man mission right there, transmission, and it's a 350, not a 305. Like I said, it's a 350 and not a 305. It's a factory 350. Now this is a GM Performance Crate 350 because the original one spun a bearing and pretty much destroyed itself. But that original engine lasted, I think, 200,000 miles or something like that. So it basically served its purpose. The truck sat for a while in this exact bay for a long time. The truck sat for quite a few years here. But then, like I said, we were going to try to
rebuild the engine, but then the crank was in two pieces. Actually, let me show you that.
All right, to continue the story, this is the original crank out of the original 350. The original block out of this truck is long gone. We got rid of it once we got the crate engine, but I thought this was pretty cool, so we always decided that we would keep this. But yeah, that's the crank. It's really heavy. So this truck drove home. Like, the crank was in two pieces, obviously. That's how we pulled it out of the engine. But when the last time he started the engine, he drove it. So he drove it home. The crank had to be broken probably on the way home. But we think he kind of remembers what happened, and we think it was broke way far away from home. He drove it home. And the crank, like I said, once we finally pulled the engine apart, the crank was in two separate pieces. So, like I said, GM Performance crank 350 right here. It runs good. Attitude Street Cars put it in. Just had a little overheating problem. That trash bag right there in front of that bucket, that's a 5.3 that I have. And I believe, I'm trying to convince him to do a 5.3 with a Whipple. Forged 5.3 or something like that, or stroke that 5.3 to 383, trying to do something cool to go in here. We were actually going to think about LT swapping this truck. We were going to get the engine that came out of my car. We're going to get that engine back. We're going to try to put it in here. But I think for his peace of mind and for him to enjoy the truck as much as he wants to, and for the cost, the LS is the way to go. That LT stuff is Justin at Stain Killer Performance and his whole crew, they are crushing this LT91 truck game. I mean, it's amazing what they're doing. I love watching it. The ZR1500 that they got going right now, plus the ZL1500. Check those out. I've talked to Justin a few times, but I don't know him like that. I'm just telling you about those trucks if you are interested in that. But LS back there in the bag, 5.3, probably can't see it too well, 5.3 there. This is my 6.0, that's a broken crank, and this is a 91 GMC. Another cool little thing that makes this truck even better is it's a 5-lug truck, but if anybody knows about Inky Wheels, Inky doesn't make truck wheels anymore. But he still has these OG Inky wheels in the front. Same set in the rear. Like I said, if you know about Inky wheels, they don't make truck wheels anymore. So he actually struggled to get a spare because he has a spare wheel on one of these. So he has 5 wheels instead of 4, basically. But it took him a lot of hunting to find that 5th wheel. But this is it. Like I said, step side. It's a bad boy. Look, factory 350 truck. You can check the facts. I'm just telling you what it is because that's what it's been ever since I was born, pretty much. So that's that. But let's talk about this and this and that and that. Ooh-wee. Let's talk about it. Well, here we are. And if you don't know what this video is about, watch some of my previous uploads. I have it up in the corner. This is my 2002 Gen 3 LS6.0. This engine, I have my 2002 Silverado. If you haven't seen that, go to my other video, because I know there's a lot of new people watching these videos. If you're part of the channel, I appreciate you guys, but I just do this so everybody knows what's going on, because sometimes the comments get a little, not annoying, but like if you just watch the video, I usually tell you everything you need to know. But anyways, this is a stock bottom end 6.0 that I'm going to put in my 2002 Silverado. Over there, you may not be able to see it, but I have a bullet racing cam, some forged pistons, and we're just waiting for the rods. Those are all going in this bottom end. But I say, and I'll probably reference this in another video, but I will say the crown jewel to this entire engine is what's in these two boxes right down here. I've always wanted what's in these two boxes right here. I've always wanted Frankenstein heads. These aren't the Big Daddy Frankenstein heads. They're not the best Frankenstein heads, but they're Frankenstein heads. I have a set of ported heads on my 5.3 that's in my 2002 Silverado right now. Texas Speed ported heads, they're pretty good. My hands are getting dirty. They're pretty good, but they're not exactly what I wanted. I loved them when I got them, but then I realized there's different ways to port a head. And like I said, or I haven't said, but this engine won't be a true max effort LS engine, but it'll be max effort to me, and I want to optimize. That's how I build my stuff, and I just optimize what it is I'm trying to build with the money that I have. I don't have all the money in the world, but so I like to make the best of what I can get. But anyways, I'm about to pop this box open. I've been waiting to do this for like 2 days. I want to do it with you guys. I'm really, really excited. So I'm going to stop talking, and I'm about to open this box. So let's do it. So, like I said, you're gonna be a part of this. Oh man. Shout out to Martin, Frankenstein Engine Dynamics. He may never see this video, but he helped me at LS Fest, and he helped me get this done. They got the shirt sent in, which is pretty sweet. Thank you. I think it's got, maybe it's Martin. Let us be a part of your bill, Stanley. Keep me posted on the results. This is definitely from Martin, because he actually, when we were talking about the LS Fest, he was actually really interested in my build. So it's definitely from Martin. So I'm definitely gonna keep him updated. It's 50 horsepower right here with the stickers. We don't need that. Let's get into it. And if you don't know, these are 243 heads that I got off eBay. Man. Ooh-wee. Look at them. I know you guys can't see them, and I don't know how to get over there. Give me 1 second. Boom. Okay. Look at all the yummy. So this is a stage one port. So it still has the stock valves. You can see some of them are still kind of dirty, but they cleaned them all up. Stage one port. Look at those runners. There we go, look at that. Stage one port. Got new seats, new springs in that bad boy. Exhaust ports are way, way bigger. If you know what a 5.3 or 6.0, the smaller engine's exhaust ports look like, they're way smaller. But look at this. Frankenstein Engine Dynamics. Look at that bad boy logo. Gonna be in your face when you hear this engine running. Man, give me 1 more second. So look at this, look at it. This whole, it just makes me so happy. I've been waiting to put these on this engine, like I said, for 2 days. And we're almost here. Also, I got the main studs in the other day. So this, like I said, this engine will be fully built to what it should be. Main studs, we're getting head studs, we're getting the rocker arms to go with it. Those are coming from Texas Speed. But look at this engine, look at it, it looks beautiful. Texas Speed, stage one, not Texas Speed, Frankenstein Engine Dynamics, my apologies, stage one ported heads. Like I said, the only advantage to the stage two is you get the upgraded valves, which is an advantage. You can run more RPM in them because they're a little bit lighter. But in my truck, I don't think we're really chasing a whole bunch of RPM. But man, this is just beautiful. It's just beautiful. Alright, so I hope you enjoyed that. This is pretty exciting to me, and I just wanted to make a video about it. This is going to be the crown jewel to your whole engine, like I said. I've got a Bullet Racing. Not Bullet Racing, I think I said Bullet Racing twice. have a cam motion cam that's going in this engine. You can watch that video to see what that cam is. These are 243 heads. You can watch that video to see what where those heads started at to what they are now. This is a 6.0 stock bottom end Gen 3. I've got a video on that. So I've got a video on this whole entire series. That's the whole point of what I'm trying to tell you. So make sure you check out what it is that I'm uploading. Subscribe to the channel to follow along, because like my man Martin said, he wants to know about the build. And I'm gonna give you guys all the information. There's nothing to hide. I'm not a grudge racer or anything like that. So I'm gonna just tell y'all what it is. So hopefully you enjoy the build and want to follow the build, but also can do the same thing yourself. These are Frankenstein Stage 1 243 heads. They don't have like a truck port like how the Texas Speed does. They just got your Stage 1 and your Stage 2, and then they have a different port for LS7s, a different port for LS3 heads, because those are do require different work. So it's not just a truck port, because these Cathedral ports on F-bodies, so your Camaros and Firebirds, your Corvettes, they came with the LS1s. These heads are very similar. These heads, 243s I believe, came on the Corvettes when they had the 6.0s. Same thing with the GTOs. So that's how Frankenstein works. Stage 1, the only advantage you get out of Stage 2 is you get the lighter valves, which I, like I said, you can make a little bit more RPM with the lighter valves. But in my truck, we're not going to be chasing RPM. Really, because it's going to be torquey with the 6.0. Just not going to be chasing RPM. It's a 24x tooth reluctor. I don't have a 48x or anything like that, so I don't really want to spin it super hard without the proper RPM readings. But anyways, that's just me being a, I don't know. Hopefully you enjoy this video. I'm just rambling now. We're going to finish up the truck really quick, and then we're going to get out of here. So make sure you like this video. Drop a comment, give this video a like I said earlier, and let me finish up really quick, I guess. So really quick, I just want to throw this in the video, that this truck is the reason why I love cars so much, why I love my truck so much, why I spend money and time working on it. This truck, my dad's had it way before I was born. Ever since I've been alive, this truck has been around. We've always worked on it. Like I told you, it has a crate engine in it right now. But we took the original engine out. I didn't learn how to drive a manual on this truck, but I've always loved manuals because my dad always had this manual. So I just wanted to throw that in there because I felt like that was important. Like I said, just for me, this truck started it all. Like, this channel probably wouldn't be a thing without this truck. So that's a cool little tidbit.